Now we're in a time like never before, okay? And this is the time I like to call the pay-to-play economy. And the reason I like to call it that, we're going to dive all into it in this episode. I'm going to break down a few questions, three specifically, that you should consider before you even think about trying to charge someone a fee or whatever. But we're going to get all into all that in this episode. Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show with Jonathan Jones. Here, you will learn how to start, launch, and monetize your podcast. In addition to hearing the latest trends and the latest and greatest things happening in the podcast industry. What's going on, family? What's going on, family? Welcome to the Your Podcast Mentor Show. And I'm your host, Jonathan Jones, and I'm excited to be here with you as always. And if you just happen to stumble over this show, this is your number one source for podcast news and podcast how-tos, all right? So today, how are we going to kick off podcast news, which is brought to you by the Get Paid with Podcasting webinar, okay? You can go to getpaidwithpodcasting.com. This is geared towards speakers, coaches, and consultants, showing you how you can leverage your voice and ultimately turn it into a profitable business, okay? Going to show you how to do that, and then also going to break that thing down even if you have a small audience. So make sure to tap into that at getpaidwithpodcasting.com. It's going to be down in the show notes. So kicking off podcast news, all right? Magellan, okay, they released the reports showing the top 15 advertisers spent over $35 million on podcasts last month. I'm just going to give you some from the top. So at the top of the list, ranking number one, bringing in $8.2 million, or spending $8.2 million on podcast advertisement would be BetterHelp, followed by Amazon at $3.4 million. Then we got Simply Safe at the 3 million mark. And then we see some people that we know, you know, the HelloFreshes, Capital One, Stamps.com, Manscaped is that 12 down at the bottom. And then we have Verizon at number 15. Of course, they got DraftKings too. Can't leave them out at number 11 with 1.8 million. And the thing I want to just highlight here is we have to pay attention where brands are spending dollars, because where brands are spending dollars lets us know ultimately where we should be paying attention. All right, where brands and companies are spending dollars, that's where we should be tapping in and paying attention. Also, one thing we want to highlight is Acast. All right, and Acast is a podcasting company for creators as well as advertisers, and they rolled out and announced that they're launching a specialized growth division, and this is designed to ultimately help podcasts scale and grow their show, or help podcasters scale and grow their shows. All right, so that right there is going to wrap it up for podcast news today, and once again, it's brought to you by the getpaidwithpodcasting.com webinar. Okay, so be sure to go ahead, click in, and tap in to that one. All right, so this episode, like I said, we're talking about the pay-to-play economy, as I want to call it. And the reason I want to break this thing down today is because you have to be careful of where you spend your money, and you have to be even more careful of where you invest your money, okay? And I'm saying that because I've been speaking for about 6 years now, as you probably heard me say before on the show, and there was a point in time to where I had invested, but I hadn't been charging, okay? So I would hop on calls with people for free, let them quote-unquote pick my brain, right? Ask me whatever questions they wanted, we would have conversations, and then I would leave feeling exhausted, and they would leave with information that they were never going to apply. Oh, God, it's only funny because it's true. So after I invested with my dad, right? I paid my dad, Dr. Fred Jones, paid him $5,000. He was my first business coach. He showed me how to ultimately write my book, how to launch my book, and how to make the book a bestseller. And you can reach out to him now. You can just type in, you can Google bestseller overnight, and then he will come up, point blank period. So understanding that, the first point I want to walk you down to is this. You have to ask yourself these three questions. And the first question is this. Before you start, you know, trying to get or compensate yourself any way, shape, or form. Have I paid what I'm charging? Period. Have you paid what you're attempting to charge someone else? Because think about it like this. If you tell me, John, in order for me to work with you, you're going to have to pay me $500. And I say, okay. And I say, have you ever invested in coaching for $500? And you say, oh, no, that's just what I'm charging you. And I say, how did you get that number? And you say, oh, well, it sounded good. No, that's not how this works. You need to invest the amount of money, at least, if you haven't invested more, into what you're expecting or requiring someone to pay you for your product, your goods, or your service. Okay, so the first question you got to ask yourself is, have I paid what I'm actually charging? Second question. You have to get clear on what's your transformation, okay? And if you don't know what your transformation is and you don't know where you're taking people, you should not even be charging anybody. You need to be sitting in somebody's masterclass or sitting in somebody's coaching program or going through somebody's course or something. But the second question is, will I create a transformation that's worth the level of investment I'm charging? Okay, transparent moment. When I first started speaking, I would speak high schools, middle schools, elementary schools, wherever, right? And when you're speaking for free, people welcome you in with open arms. There is no risk for the speaker, because at the end of the day, if you are good, then they're like, oh, wow, great, you did an amazing job. If you're terrible, then they just say, oh, we're not going to bring him back. Oh, he was free. Hey, he was free. No big deal. He was free. Hey, you know, we didn't lose nothing. So what am I saying? What I'm saying is this. First, you must identify what transformation that you're bringing. And then you want to quantify what is the value of that transformation, right? So let's say you can help somebody lose 15 pounds in 30 days. What's the value of that? How do you quantify that? And then after you quantify the value, the price that people are willing to pay more than likely is going to be like maybe half of the value, right? Because it's just one of those marketing things, and there's a lot more psychology to it, and we can go into that another episode, but that's not the focus today. So I want you to begin to think and process through that. Are you bringing a transformation that's at least worth the price that you're charging? Or is the transformation greater than the price that you're charging, right? So I said losing weight, that's a great one. Because you're giving, the transformation is, you're giving somebody back more time on earth by helping them be more healthy, by helping them live a ketogenic lifestyle, right? And then the third question I want you to ask yourself is this. Do I believe that I can actually meet the objectives that are requested of me? I had a coach reach out to me earlier this week. He's a good friend of mine. He coaches a football program. And he said, Jonathan, man, what's going on? I said, Coach, what's the deal? He said, Jay, look, we started looking for guest speakers to bring to the school. And you were the first person I thought of. I said, Coach, I appreciate that. I really do. But I said, Coach, what's the theme that you all are looking to address? He said, oh, the theme is diversity, equity, and inclusion. I said, hold on. Hold on, Coach. Hold on. And I said, well, what do you want the students to take away after? He said, well, John, one thing I want them to take away is understanding that when we talk about diversity, equity, inclusion, we want to make sure that people feel like they belong. And he began to just break that down. I said, Coach, I really don't talk about, you know, DEI type work. I really don't do the diversity, equity, and inclusion type work. I respect it, but I think there's somebody else that could do a better job. You know, I said, you know, I talk about podcasting and how you can build your brand and ultimately how that can help elevate an individual, a student, a young professional. And he said, yeah, John, well, we can put a twist on it. And then we can talk about how people share their stories and how ultimately through them sharing their stories, now they're opening themselves up to the rest of the world and bringing together a culture of belonging. And I said, well, coach, if that's the case, then I can address that. But if we're talking about diversity, equity, and inclusion, I don't know if that's going to be the ministry for me, coach. Why did I tell you that story? I told you that story because I want you to understand. The final question. Do I believe that I can meet the objectives that are requested of me? If they were just talking about diversity, equity, and inclusion, I would have had to sit that one out. Just because there's money attached to the opportunity does not always make it the best opportunity for you. So let's be clear today in this pay for play economy. Let's be clear. You're going to pay somewhere. You're going to pay either in time, you're going to pay in tears, or you're going to pay a mentor that's made like the mistakes and who has made the mistakes for you so that they can help you navigate away from those things. But I urge you that before you jump out here and just start trying to charge people and tell people how much they need to pay and just putting the price of $9.97 on your products and services because everybody else is doing it, just make sure that you've paid $9.97 first. Before you tell people that they should pay you a $10,000 fee for you to speak anywhere, make sure that you've paid $10,000 somewhere in your development. Right? Because it's one thing for you to go to school for career day and talk to the class, but it's another thing for you to be the keynote speaker and they be expecting you to perform. And if you don't have the background, and if you don't have the practice, if you don't have the structure, and you don't have the ability, that's going to be a problem. Because now you're going to not only sever a relationship, you're going to make that individual look bad. And then they're going to tell 5 to 7 other people about the horrible experience that they had with you. And that could ultimately, for lack of better terms, blackball your business. All right. So I want to make sure that you all are aware of those questions. But before we do the recap, I want to make sure that also you're aware of the Get Paid with Podcasting training coming up. Okay, we're going to have the link down in the show notes. And ultimately, I'm going to show you how to establish your authority in your industry, be the go-to expert, how you can explode your leads, and how you can even generate revenue, even if you don't have a lot of followers. Okay, the link is going to be down there in the show notes, getpaidwithpodcasting.com. And now for the recap. Okay. So today we're talking about the pay-for-play economy, and I said that you must ask yourself these 3 questions before you get ready to charge somebody else, okay? The first question is this. Have I paid what I'm charging for my product, for my good, for my service? Have I paid the amount that I'm requesting? If you have not, you need to go back to the drawing board. And you need to invest somewhere, period, because you need some coaching, all right? Especially if you're a speaker, coach, or consultant, you need some coaching, period. Okay, the second question that you have to ask yourself is, will I create a transformation that's worth the level of investment? Think about it like this. You charging somebody $1,000 for some French fries. They're not going to be pleased with that. That's why when you pay for French fries, you're paying probably like around $5, maybe $10 if you go out to eat. Period. Third question you have to ask yourself is, do I believe I can meet the objectives that are requested of me? Do I believe in my heart of heart, in my heart of hearts, do I believe that I can meet the objectives that are requested of me? The coach asked me to speak on diversity, equity, and inclusion. I said, you know, I speak on podcasting. I had to be firm. If you know that you don't address the topic that somebody is reaching out to you for, if you know that that's not your ministry, you need to refer that client. You need to refer that client. John, why do I need to refer that client? You need to refer that client because you're probably going to do more damage than good for your business and theirs by you trying to be all things to all people, and you're going to turn around being nothing to no one. Family, I just want to let you know, if you felt that this episode added any value to you whatsoever, I would just ask you to do two things, okay? The first would be to go to your podcast mentor show, and you can feel free to hit that buy me a coffee down at the bottom left-hand side, little coffee logo. And then you can, you know, send me a little something, give me a little love offering. Or if you felt this show is valuable, you can go to yourpodcastmentorshow.com, and then you can leave a rate and review on the show, right? Say what you liked, say what you took out. And then the third thing is, I'm not asking you to do it, but I want to give you a gift. And my gift to you would be, you can click that microphone on the podcast website, and then you can ask your question, right? And then have the opportunity for your question to be featured on podcast Q&A with JJ right here on the Your Podcast Mentor Show, all right? So family, I appreciate you rocking with me. I appreciate you taking time to come out and tune into the show. And as you know, that I'm here to help you establish your platform so that ultimately you can profit on purpose from your podcast. Till next time, peace and God bless.